Greetings, traders, and welcome back. Thank you for joining me again, as always. Chris here, bringing you another survival guide. Today's subject will be Fibonacci retracement. This is a powerful tool slash indicator, depending on which platform you're using, and it has been around for a very long time, and it is one of my personal favorites. I used it in the beginning of my trading career, and it's still something to this day that I still employ from time to time. So I am excited to bring some Fibonacci information to you. We're going to talk about what it is, how it works, how it's calculated, as well as use it on some charts so you see some practical application of it. But before we go any further, let's show you how you can apply it to your charts using the Finamark platform. That way you can follow along the entire time. Now, in order to find this on the Finamark platform, it is located under the drawing tools, not the indicator section. So that means we need to click on the pen icon, which says show drawing panel. And on the left-hand column here, you'll see a selection of choices. There are three horizontal lines next to a white box. If we click on that, we have now selected the Fibonacci retracement tool. As you can see, there are a number of different settings here that we can change. I do not recommend changing any of these settings aside from the opacity, as well as the extend levels horizontal selection down here at the bottom, which I'm going to check that off right now, because when I use my Fibonacci retracement tool, I like to see those levels extended on to the right. That way I can continue to see how they're going to perform as the market continues to progress. But without further ado, let's dive on into the material and learn a thing or two about the Fibonacci retracement tool. The Fibonacci retracement tool is based upon the Fibonacci sequence naturally, and the Fibonacci sequence is something that is occurring on a daily basis, and it has been recurring in all forms of life, let it be a tree ring or even your very own ear. It's a very precarious, interesting sequence that likes to repeat itself and continues to present itself, so it's only natural that it has found a way to indoctrinate itself into the trading world. But as far as the retracement tool, it is nothing more than an indicator that is adding horizontal lines to a chart to indicate potentially notable levels of support and resistance. The Fibonacci retracement tool can be used on any index, futures chart, currency exchange, etc. If it can be plotted, the Fibonacci retracement tool can be applied. Many traders use the Fibonacci retracement as a respectable source of a buy or sell signal, and that's even saying that they're not applying anything else to it. We have traders that are using nothing more than the Fibonacci retracement tool to pass the gauntlet mini, so it is definitely worth paying attention to if you think you have what it takes. Many traders believe, because the Fibonacci retracement tool is so prevalent and so believed in by traders across the world, that it has become more of a self-fulfilling prophecy. When traders see an area that may be a notable Fibonacci level, we then in turn see a large portion of traders reacting to that level, creating the reaction that people expected at that level to begin with because of the Fibonacci numbers and the Fibonacci retracement tool itself. The Fibonacci retracement tool and the Fibonacci sequence naturally is named after someone called Fibonacci. And you would think that someone with a name of Fibonacci was probably a famous Italian artist or musician, but in reality, he was neither of those. He was actually a mathematician born in 1170 AD, originally known as Leonardo of Pisa, a little bit less exciting of a name. He only earned the name Fibonacci post-mortem. That's because it didn't become popularized, his ideas of the sequence, until after his death, unfortunately. Fibonacci's numbers have been at the center of a controversy amongst traders for quite some time. There are traders who advocate for it, and then there are traders that argue against it because they can't justify why it should work, even though there are multiple instances and recordings of it actually working. The numbers suggest that the patterns they form have an inherent meaning that can be applied to trading as well as all of the other things that they're found in life. The typical counter-argument is that it is simply a function of mob psychology, which kind of falls back to that self-fulfilling prophecy idea. But at the end of the day, as long as it is doing something in a manner that we can expect, do we as traders really need to care why it's working? Instead, understanding that it's going to work is usually far more valuable to us than understanding why it should work. Because the Fibonacci retracement tool is based upon the Fibonacci sequence, it's important to understand what the Fibonacci sequence is. And here it is up at the top. It is 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34, 55, and 89. Now, if you are astute with math or solving problems, you may be aware that there is a pattern here. It may not look it if this is your first time seeing the Fibonacci sequence, but in reality, what's going on with this number sequence is every two numbers is added to create the third. So, what do we have to get to 2? 1 plus 1 equals what? It equals 2. What do we have to get to 3? 2 plus 1 equals 3. How do we get to 5? 2 plus 3 equals 5, and so on and so forth, all the way out to 89. Now, what's worth noting about the sequence is as the sequence progresses, as we work our way to the final number in our listed sequence of 89, each number gets closer and closer to 61.8%. And this is considered the golden ratio in the world of the Fibonacci retracement tool and just in the Fibonacci sequence world to begin with. And that's where our first actual level comes from. So traders that are trading with the Fibonacci retracement tool are usually favoring the 61.8% level of retracement of whatever move they're measuring more so for an expected level of support or resistance than most of the other Fibonacci levels, but that's not to discredit them. So let's talk about how we actually come up with these other numbers. To get the first retracement level, it was simply 55 divided by 89. 55 divided by 89 gave us the 61.8 that we're talking about. To get the second number in the ratio, we're just going to go another number over and then come back to our 89. So that would be 34 divided by 89. And what is that going to give us? It'll give us our 38.2. And to continue on down the line, what happens when we take our 21 and divide it by our 89? Well, then we're going to be given our 23.6. So this is how the numbers are generated. And going by that logic, dividing 1 by 1, if we continue down, is going to give us a 100% ratio, which is where our 100 comes from in one of our relevant Fibonacci ratios. So we have a 100, and dividing 1 by 2 is going to give us 50%, which is going to give us our 50% ratio. But you may notice there's one left over. Let's go ahead and look at our 76.4 and see how in the world did we come up with that? Well, in order to get our 76.4, we're going to subtract our 23.6% from 100. If we subtract our 23.6% from 100, we get our final retracement level of 76.4. Now, this is arguably one of the less used Fibonacci retracement levels, but it is worth noting because it is still definitely used, and I want to provide you guys with all of the information. So, the important level, if you are just getting into the Fibonacci retracement world, the number one level to pay attention to, in my mind, is going to be the 61.8. That's this guy right here. here. 61.8 is our golden ratio. Some other very notable levels would be the 50% as well as the 38.2, roughly in that order. The 38.2 and the 50 arguably go back and forth with which traders value more, but these are the top three hands down, in my opinion, of the Fibonacci retracement levels. These are the ones that we are mostly going to be hunting for. So if you don't want to remember any crazy math, if you don't want to remember anything else going on, just remember the 38.2, the 50%, and the 61.8. And also, because we live in a beautiful world of computers and technology, we don't have to do the math ourselves to generate these levels. But the way that we would do the math is obviously quite simple. We're measuring a percentage distance based on these ratios, which we already generated from the sequence, and we're just applying that to a swing low and a swing high in price. So if we were measuring a swing low to a swing high, we're paying attention and marking off from that swing low to that swing high with our Fibonacci retracement tool, and it's going to auto mark off the 61.8. It's going to auto mark off a 50% and a 38.2. And what these percentages are, these are percentages of the retracement of the move that we are measuring. So that means if we make it to the 50% is always going to be exactly 50%. It's going to be dead in the middle of the movement that we are measuring. 61.8% would mean that price has fallen just a tad beyond 50% and instead reached our golden ratio of our 61.8 and so on and so forth. So the concept of Fibonacci and how it's calculated is really not that complicated. And luckily, we don't even have to really do any of the math. The most important thing to take away, once again, is these three numbers right here. Now, let's have some fun and apply the Fibonacci indicator to some moves in the market, from some swing lows to some swing highs, and see how it would have potentially helped us. And starting with the E-mini S&P 500, we are currently on an hourly chart. This is only a couple days ago, this information. And what we're taking a look at here is we're going to draw from a swing low to a swing high, or we're going to draw from a swing high to a swing low. So a particularly directional move is what we're looking to measure with the Fibonacci retracement tool. Now remember, I do have my extend levels horizontally box checked off. If yours does not have this, you're going to have to stretch yours out or turn it on if you want it to look exactly the same as mine is about to. So to go from my first swing low down here, I'm going to mark off from the bottom of my move, and I'm going to mark off to the top of my move. At this point, let's say, and get rid of that box, that we saw the market begin exhibiting some bearish momentum. Well, if we are trading in real time, one thing that we always know is we know where the current high point is in the market, and we can continuously adjust that higher if we need to. So marking off where the high is of the particular swing high doesn't require a whole degree of particular skill, but instead it is simply measuring a low point to a high point, and you're going from the left to the right always. Or if you are measuring a downward move and you want to see how the market may retrace that downward move and actually come back up, then you would be measuring from the top to the bottom, but it is still from the left to the right. So in this case, we measured the move right here where we went from the bottom to the top of this strong bullish push, and we're going to get some levels plotted out here by our Fibonacci indicator. The first one naturally is going to represent a 38.2% retracement if the market goes down. It'll show us where 38.2% of this move would be. So this is our first area to be on the lookout for a potential area of support or some type of a reaction to occur, would be right around the 38.2, which is right here. And at this point, we noticed that we actually got a nice little bounce in the market off of this, and it actually did temporarily function as an area of support on the way up, coincidentally. Now, once again, in order to get this, we had to draw to this top portion, so we wouldn't have seen this level until over here. So for the purposes of this swing low, it could have actually been valuable to us, but this one we wouldn't have seen just yet. But let's let's erase those and keep taking a look. Our next notable level is going to be the 50%. And I'm going to switch my colors to white to make them a little bit easier. At 50%, what did we get? We found another nice, beautiful support bounce. And this one was a very nice one indeed, because not only did we bounce off of this, but the market actually went on to set a new high up here. So the 50%, which is right here, is going to extend all the way through price. And as you'll notice, this was an area that actually became a very important and pivotal point in the market as we continue forward, even farther away from this move, and even after we already set new highs. So it is interesting to pay attention to these levels because, once again, it's an easy way to identify potentially pivotal points in the market. And if we have an expectation that something may be bouncing, and then we apply a little bit of price action or some exterior knowledge to it, we're giving ourselves a very big leg up over what others may be seeing in the market and getting ourselves in at an advantageous time. But as we move along, let's check out our 61.8%. As we follow this line over, we see another beautiful bounce when we approached it. So yet again, we found a bounce as well as a flip into an area of resistance for some time once we finally fell below it over here. This is an interesting occurrence. And once again, this is what's considered our golden ratio. This 61.8, although it's not hit as frequently as the 50 because the market requires to, or is required to move farther, it is still a beautiful area to pay attention to. And now let's go ahead and move this guy over here. Oh, actually, we'll just draw an entirely new one so you get used to it. Now let's measure a down move. So we're going to go from the top of the move to the bottom of the move. And this is relatively simple. All we're going to do here is, once again, go left to right from the top to the bottom if it's a downward move, or if it's an upward move, we're going, once again, from the left to the right, just from the bottom to the top. If you go from the left to the right, it's always going to keep you on the right side of your drawing tool. Now, as we take a look at our levels, let's see what happened here. So we were measuring a downward move, so we wanted to be on the lookout where some retracement resistance may be found on the way back up. So at this point, we found our first substantial area of resistance. And what do you know? It's actually right around a previous Fibonacci level. Here is the pattern repeating itself in one way or another. This is that fractal nature to it. So with 38.2, what do we have? We have an area of resistance that was encountered in the market. And this is an area that was encountered in the market that we absolutely would have been able to see and use in real time. Because once again, if this represents our bottom and we had our levels extended outwards, everything to the right is going to be fair game. So let's go ahead and just take a look at the next level. Where is it? It's our 50%. Let's follow it across and see what happened. Well, what do you know? We actually encountered a little bit of resistance at this area. And then we got a temporary breakthrough where did we go? We went to the 61.8. Right at the 61.8, we rejected and had our most beautiful example of rejection for this particular move, the golden ratio holding its number. And it's worth noting that along the way down, we got stuck back underneath the level of 50%, continued to use it as resistance, and we actually bounced back up off of the 38.2. So I'm sure you're already seeing the potential value here with the Fibonacci retracement tool. It is an incredibly powerful tool, and I can draw these levels all day on any chart, on anything that can be charted, and we will start to find these beautiful occurrences where the market is undeniably finding areas of support or resistance around these key ratios. And once again, the ones that we always want to pay attention to at least the most is our 38.2, our 50, and our 61.8. Now, the other ratios obviously can be valuable as well, and they are worth taking note of, but these are going to be our golden ratios. So to wrap it all up, the Fibonacci retracement tool is incredibly powerful, yet very, very lightweight. It's based upon a sequence that has been around since the 1100s. It's something that continues to show its worth. And you know what I love to say about these things. The things that have been around the longest usually are around for a reason. If it didn't work, it would fall away into the ether and we would never hear about it again. I strongly recommend checking out the Fibonacci retracement tool and giving it a little bit of practice, especially if you think you have what it takes to pass the gauntlet mini. But until next time, folks, please remember to click the like and subscribe button down below and be my friend. I will see you all very soon. Cheers, folks. Over and out.